Amazing,
Hiya, hi
everybody.
everyone. Cool.
So, good
Do you want
evening. This is the very first episode of the Waffle Sessions with me, Kirsty Raven, mindset mentor and online entrepreneur.
And my name's Meg. I'm a self-love advocate and also an online entrepreneur as well.
Just want to say thank you to everyone for tuning in. It's our very first time doing this, and we're trying to do it across two platforms. So bear with us. You know, there might be a few hiccups along the way, but you know, we're all good with that. So you really need to stick around if you want to find out how we ended up here, how we ended up starting a podcast on this final day of the longest month of the year.
It's done. It's dusted.
2022 officially starts right now. So, how did we get here, Meg? How did we end up?
Have no idea. No, I do have an idea. I think we just wanted to start off like with our journeys and like how we did end up here, because there is a bit of a backstory for those of you that don't know. Some of you may have heard this who have joined, but for anyone who doesn't know. So yeah, I'm Meg and I joined the online space a little over a year ago now, and I started an online business. Started a business a little over a year ago, and joining the online space has kind of really kind of thrown me in the deep end of kind of the personal development and really working on myself, and that's kind of where I've led to. Talking about kind of self-love and confidence and just wanting to help other people. And I think it's really helped the power of the online community that Kirsty and I actually met through. And it's just amazing how being in the online space and you end up meeting people that you just never would cross paths with probably in everyday life.
Yeah,
And
let's
you
put on
just
that because we are actually from two different generations, really. You know,
you
like,
wouldn't be able to tell because Kirsty literally looks about my age. You can't really, we won't disclose
really
how
good
much you
ring
are.
light. Thank you very much. But you know, there is a generational gap in terms of our ages, isn't there? And we wouldn't have met if we hadn't ended up in this, you know, online community. And we're very fortunate that we have actually met in person, but we've only actually met in person twice before now. And, you know, that online community has given that opportunity to me and Meg to have met each other, which is pretty amazing, really.
And we've like got a whole load of other people that we've connected with who are just amazing. So yeah, it's been a little over a year now, and I've literally, as I said, I've taken a dive into personal development, and I'm a completely changed woman to where I was a year ago. And if you had told me over a year ago that I would be sat here doing a podcast with a girl called like woman called Kirsty, I'd be like, what? What is going on, man? Which is just nuts. And that's kind of why we were doing this. It's kind of stepping out of our comfort zone, you know, show like building our confidence and just wanting to help other people as well, and just sharing our voice really, because I think a lot of my barriers has been my self-belief and my confidence. And I now believe I've got to a stage where actually somebody will want to listen to me, and I can provide value to someone somewhere in the world. And that's why I'm here. That's how I've really got here. And Kirsty came to me and put this idea to me, and I literally jumped at it. So thanks to Kirsty, this has kind of come to
It was
fruition,
a little
really.
dream that I had.
Yeah. So
A little
this
dream
is
that
day
I had.
one. I'm
And
so
again,
excited for the journey, though.
like I
I'm
said
buzzing.
before, like we've come from, you know, different generations, different backgrounds. And I think I can speak for both of us that we probably get talked about by other people as being confident people. And people would look at us and say, you'll be fine, you're confident. And it comes back down to that inner belief, that inner self-belief that I don't know when I lost it, but I lost it somewhere along my journey. And I think it's for all the challenges that I faced on my journey, in different environments. And people kind of label you with that, you're fine, you're confident. But actually, what was going on inside was something completely different. So you then get this really kind of, you're like torn between what people kind of see you as and what you really know that you are. And then that is where the kind of like disconnect comes in, and you feel like that. I felt like an imposter. I felt 100%. Like people were seeing me as something that I wasn't, you know.
It's like you're put into a box, isn't it? Like, Kirsty knows, like, it as a teenager, I was put in this box as a big, bubbly, confident Meg. And yes, on the external I was, like, you saw me and I was laughing all the time and I'm really confident. But deep, like, yeah, like you say, deep down, I just wasn't, like, in myself. And that's kind of the journey that I've been on. And that's where we really connected, I think. I think we both saw that in each other pretty early on. So, yeah.
I think that's another good point, isn't it? It's like we have joined an online community. It's being in the online space is not something that either of us have ever done before. And we, you know, there's sort of things that we do on a daily basis, things that put us out of our comfort zone. And then you start kind of like a ball rolling, and then you start putting yourself out of your comfort zone. And that's kind of, I think, where we've got to at a point where we've been honest with ourselves. We've actually turned around and said, you've got work to do on yourself, you know, internally. And it just so happens that Meg and I have kind of ended up at the same point at the same time on that journey, really. And now we're able to kind of use that confidence that we're now building externally to kind of share our experience and kind of end up here, really. You know, I think, for me, I've also been in this business for about a year, and it probably took me at least four months, maybe more like six, to admit to myself that I had some work to do. And it isn't that I think I was just lying to myself. It was like delusional, basically. I was just saying to myself, I was believing people saying to me, you're fine, you're confident, you're this, that and the other. And I wasn't listening to what I was saying to myself on the inside. And when I realised there was two different things going on, I was actually, it's almost like talking to that inner child, isn't it? I was able to kind of pull out that person that I was.
That's exactly what it is that the inner child, that's what we had. Like, it's just nuts when you put it like that, actually.
It's learning to love that inner child and explain to the inner child that it's okay. It's okay to, from my point of view, for me, some of this came from the fact that if I made mistakes or didn't do things right when I was growing up, I didn't get the attention, the same attention as if I was doing well. So I always had this thing where I needed to be really good, a high achiever, because then I got the attention. And it took me a very long time to realise that was what I was doing. So when I started to fail at certain things, I didn't know how to handle it.
Yeah, I completely resonate with that. And I'm sure a lot of people watching this probably would as well. And that's where, for me, having, I've talked about a lot on my socials lately, is just that validation. I was always seeking validation from people, just always needing it. It was unhealthy. It was so unhealthy. And it's just getting to that stage. And I think it's really crazy now that I've got to the point, and I don't know if you agree, but it's mad how there's so many people in this world that don't actually have the opportunity or know how to actually fully understand themselves. And we're in that position now where we have that opportunity. And that's kind of like another reason why I would love to do this, is just to help people that, you know, who might come across our podcast, to actually trigger something in them to think, oh, actually, I do need to work on myself a bit more. And it is possible. And just to help people, really, because some people just go through life just completely thinking that how they're feeling is normal, and I there's actually a reason to it. There's a reason to it, and you can help yourself.
Yeah, it's that feeling like you're the only person that thinks like that, isn't it? And I think for most of my life, whatever I was saying internally made me feel like I was the only one. And it's having that safe space, having that community, having people like us that, you know, obviously sharing those experiences, that make you realize you're not alone, you know, like. And it's we've realized we're not alone because we have very similar kind of like stories, and we've shared that story, and it's enabled us to grow. So the more you share, the more you grow, and the more you can feel confident and put yourself out of your comfort zone and, you know, really move forward in life, you know. And I think it's definitely that being able to share not the fake version, the real version, the version that's on the inside, the version that's been hiding for so long. And that is where my confidence is actually really coming from, the true.
Yeah. And it's being able to show that as well. I think, you know, Kirsty, like recently, I've kind of had now the confidence to actually talk about part of my story that I would just bottle up. And it's really important to talk about these things and just to be open and be true to yourself. And like you say, we've just kind of had a wake up call and realized there's work that we need to do on ourselves, I guess.
Yeah.
That's kind of like where we want to go with this podcast, I think. One of the reasons, just to help people.
But
And waffle.
It's unplanned chat, actually. And what I think is really, you know, fascinating about our relationship, mine and Meg's relationship, is that we actually only met for the first time in August. Mm-hmm. And our online community organised an event where we met up in London. And it's such a strange experience. We'd only really connected a couple of times, I think, through one of the lives I did or one of the lives you did in the community. And then at this event, I've leant over this, you know, this barrier, and someone shouts my name, and I'm like, what? Oh my god, it's her, it's Meg, oh my god, you know, like,
did I do that?
No, you didn't. You were like, Kirsty.
That sounds like me.
And I was like, this is my girl. And it's that, that's, I felt like funny. I'd known you forever.
Yeah, literally. It was like, we just, like, I think I remember that now. Maybe. It was probably me just, but that again is like coming out confident. It was probably just a nervous, like, shout across the room. Oh God, so funny.
I think for me as well, from there to now, I don't know what it is other than that. I think just the more I've spoken about the inside me, those feelings, the more I've been able to kind of step on them and kind of grow. But from August to now, I would say I've massively grown as a person. That confidence
has just come out of nowhere.
You feel like that as well?
Yeah, you have. I can tell you have massively. Mm. Yeah.
It was always there, but it was like, I don't know, there's a shyness that I had that seemed to just overtake me. And even at that event in London, I definitely didn't talk to as many people as I should have. And it was like, oh, why would that person want to talk to me? And you say all stuff like that. You start being all like, oh no, I can't be doing any of that.
Oh God, that's so funny.
And then to now, you know, like, I would actually say, I don't know if I wouldn't have probably been ready for this in August at all, but that's a short amount of time.
And this is even like bringing it back to like my online business and probably yours, is the first year I had so much work to do that there was no way I was ready to fully run my business the way I wanted to, because I had a lot of work to do internally to, and it's all about, and I know we've discussed this a lot, it's always having that vision in front of you of becoming the person you want to be. And I've read somewhere, it's kind of like, you have to fake it till you make it. You literally have to act as if you are that person that you want to be, and just stepping outside your comfort zone. Like, and yeah, for me, I have that vision of that woman I want to be, and I know I'm getting there gradually. And this year I'm now ready to smash goals in my business that I probably wasn't ready to do last year. So
I think that for me is the thing. It's like, yeah, like you said, fake it before you make it, be it before you see it, all of that stuff. Mm-hmm. But I think first you have to know who is that person you want to be. Who you want to be. And you have to really do some internal listening and internal work on yourself, because you get moulded into what people think you should be, or get moulded into a box, and you kind of like, you just sort of go with the flow with it, and you don't kind of like challenge it. And all of a sudden you're in this environment where you've got all these amazing people around you, all kind of like doing wonderful, crazy things. And you're like, who am I in this space? Who am I? What, you know, which part do I feel here?
Yeah.
And I think that's, for me, that's the bit that took the time in the first place, was like, who do I want to be? What kind of message do I want to share with people? And, you know, at the start, you think, no one wants to listen to me. What have I got to say?
Yeah. And I know deep down, I have always dreamed of wanting to help people like with their self-work, like and self-image and their self-confidence. But it was like last year, there's no way I had the confidence to talk about it to anyone because that's the work I need to do. But now I've got to the point where I'm becoming more comfortable with being vulnerable with people, with sharing that side to me, because it's always been there. I've just been too scared to show it. And always had to try and be, you know, confident, brave Meg, I guess, yeah. The box that I've been put in for so many years.
I think in the normal world, and not the online world, life moves so fast, doesn't it? And you're with, you know, whatever jobs we've done, you are, it's mapped out by whoever's running that company. And however they see their vision, however they see their company, is how you sort of follow suit. So you aren't really ever able to sit back and go, oh, you're not given the platform really to sit back and go, you know, what do you think? How should we do things? Or you just kind of like follow like a little sheep, really. And I was talking earlier on a live I did earlier about, you know, my career really was what I thought was my dream job. But actually, whilst it was a dream job, it's a load of old bollocks, isn't it? Because a dream job doesn't give you your dream life. A dream job is still a job, and the job that only supports somebody else's dream and empire. Like, mental when you think
about it. It's nuts, isn't it?
It is.
And it takes a lot. It takes a while for people to change that mindset as well, and to really fully understand it. It's taken me a while to kind of get my head around it, but here we are.
Doing a podcast after a little dream that I had.
Literally, this podcast, she said she came to me, she goes, Meg, you're in my dream. I was like, what? I've only met you
not
twice.
Like that. If anyone saw my reel earlier, but this is like the conversation. I have with
that
myself
person with the sunglasses. The I think this is the right one. Was definitely me a year ago.
Going, I don't want to mess it up. Yeah.
Only that one's the that one was me.
I know, but it is. It's that, isn't it? And I think even now, when we're talking about this podcast that we're doing, we could have spent another probably 6 months planning, preparing, getting the technical bit right. You know, we talked about different streaming technologies and all that kind of stuff. And in the end, we just went, fuck it. Use my language, but fuck it. If we mess up, so
we
what?
We didn't plan that, by the way. It just happened.
Jinx.
Oh my God,
it's too funny. Too funny.
Yeah, fuck it.
And that is exactly the place we're at right now, because in a year's time, like, we'll have done however many of these, 52 of these, and we'll be able to look back every single one of those early ones and learn from it. So if you don't start, you can't ever learn from it. So you just got to be open to messing up. And I think it was Camila actually did a reel earlier about, you know, loving the failures and actually don't be embarrassed by the failures, just go with it, you know.
I literally have visions of me not being able to save this and me just deleting it.
That's why I've done it on Zoom. That's why I can actually, it's recorded. It's even got the bits recorded before we went live on both platforms. And I won't say what we said there.
We don't want to know what we said then.
Basically, that I think it seems to be a bit of the theme of the day, doesn't it? Like, just fuck it. Just do it. Don't sit around thinking about it for too long. If we sit there and kind of wait till we're ready, you're never going to get anywhere and you're never going to learn anything. So if it's imperfect, so what? So what? Who cares? And I think if you're an entrepreneur in this world, that has to be your mantra, because you're never, ever going to learn. You're never, ever going to grow. And you're never, ever going to move forward if you don't just say, fuck it every now and again. I'm just going to do it and see what happens.
Yeah. I even think for people who don't want to go into entrepreneurship, just in everyday life, like, just do things that, if you want to do it, just bloody do it. Like, even if it is stepping outside your comfort zone and you're scared or whatever, like, I've said this many times on a couple of lives, I think. The feeling that you have when you're scared is the exact same feeling as when you're excited about something.
Mm.
It's the butterflies in your tummy, the sweaty palms, and it's the exact same thing that happens in your body. So if you're like really scared, just like reframe it in your mind and think, actually, no, I'm really excited about this. I'm really excited about this. And when I heard that, I was like, wow, that's actually really true. Like, so whenever I get scared now, I just, I did that on my live. Did you, Rob? Oh, I need to replay that.
Yeah, sorry, Rob, I'll do a replay that. Replay that in a minute. I think we were too busy getting ready for this. Working out what exactly we were going to waffle about. We shouldn't plan it at all, and we still haven't planned it. Paralysis is the death of action. I think that is the thing, and I think I actually did say that to you, Rob, earlier, didn't I? Is that confident? If you just tell yourself confidence isn't a thing, right? So confidence isn't a thing. You've just got to take action. So forget about all that fear, and as Meg just said, switch that in your head, reframe it, and just do it. What is the worst that can happen? Like, unless you're going to die, you know. Really, what is the worst that can happen? All you're going to do is do something. You might fuck up. You might be able to laugh at yourself, and you'll definitely learn from it. And that's it, isn't it? That's all that matters, really. None of the other stuff matters at all.
And it is easier said than done. It's not easy. It is hard, but it's just trying. Just keep trying, and that's what we've done. I think over the past few months is just keeping at it and keeping going and not giving up.
And just don't let one little blip stop you, you know? One little blip, just keep moving over it. Step over it and go again. Step over it and go again. I think we are really fortunate that we do have our online community and that we do have that safe space and that support. And, you know, we've got each other for support, and there's other people. Camila's here as well. You know, like, we are very fortunate to have that. And I think whatever you do, whatever you're trying to achieve, is having your support network is really important. So whether that's a big community like we've got, or just your best mate or someone that you can lean on, really.
Definitely. Okay.
Dust yourself off and carry on. Isn't there a song there?
Exactly.
Dust yourself off and try again. Is that
one? Oh my God, go on, Kirsty. We're going to turn this into a little show now, are we?
I didn't mean to sing that. I do, don't mind a bit of karaoke. What about you? Do you like karaoke or not?
I don't like karaoke.
I'm not saying I'm good, but I just, mic's in my hand, that's it. I turn into a diva.
It kind of out a little bit, but you know, each to your own.
When I used to live in Cardiff, there was this place, I think it was called Lucky Voice, and you'd get your own like booth. So if you had like six or seven of you, you'd have this little karaoke booth, and there was like a little button on the side, so if you needed a drink, you press the button, they came with the tray. And then it wasn't like you were in a big room of people. You could literally just in front of your mates with your mic and go for it. It was brilliant.
I think I went to one of those in Bristol, and it's like a Chinese state, like Chinese, like all you can eat as well. It was really strange, like you go for your Chinese all you can eat, and then there's like a karaoke section. Like, similar to that.
They love it in China, don't they? They call it KTV. Where they go.
Oh, do they?
Yeah.
I was really loved going time. Oh, God.
Lucky Voices in Brighton, too. Yeah, the one in Cardiff used to be behind, I think it was called Tiger Tiger, like nightclub, and then you kind of go out the back.
Tiger Tiger. You're throwing it back now,
girl. It was a long time ago that I lived in Cardiff. I don't know if it's still. Oh, God.
Anyway, we're going to keep consistent with this, aren't we? 8 p.m. on Mondays.
8 p.m. Mondays, every Monday, without fail, no matter where we are, what we're doing, we will jump on at 8 o'clock.
Yeah. And thank you for listening.
Maybe we'll bring the wine next week. I've only got tea now.
So. We can do that.
Yeah, let's do that.
On a Monday. This is partly why I wanted to do it on a Monday, because it made me look forward to Mondays.
That's a great idea. Didn't even think of that.
Yeah, it's great. This has been great. This is a great first episode. I think it's
really good. I'm loving it. I'm really loving it. I think it's worked really well.
Right. Anyway, thank you guys for listening.
Bye, everybody. See you later.
Love yours.
Bye.